my God.
Okay, this is out of control. This planet is unstable and inhospitable.
Atlas, my name is Smith.
Is that really necessary? You're a computer program.
I'm driving through hell and out of Brosco.
No, I'm not.
No? What are you then?
I am a computer program named Smith.
No one likes a smart-ass Smith. We don't have much time. Harlan's planning an attack.
Atlas, my primary protocol is to keep you alive.
Same! I don't need your help. I don't trust any AI. Smith?
Okay, this is out of control.
Hello everyone and welcome to another movie review. I am happy that you could join me today. If you are new to this channel, welcome. Click the subscribe button below for future notifications and updates. Click the like button and share this content with other fans. Okay, so yesterday was Friday, May 24th, the beginning of the Memorial Day weekend. And boy, was I busy yesterday watching new movies. It was a lot, but I'm gonna get through them one by one. So the first movie I saw yesterday was Atlas. Okay, Atlas is a sci-fi action film directed by Brad Peyton, starring Jennifer Lopez, Simu Liu, Sterling K. Brown, and Mark Strong. I'm still suffering from allergies. It premiered on Netflix, and the running time is approximately 2 hours. So, Jennifer Lopez plays Atlas Shepard, a counterterrorism analyst who embarks on a mission to capture an AI humanoid robot named Harlan, played by Simu Liu, who has gone rogue, and he is on a mission to wipe out the human race. However, to defeat Harlan, she has to rely on another AI robot named Smith. Because Atlas' mother created Harlan, and Harlan is responsible for her mother's death, Atlas has a deep distrust of AI. So it takes most of the second act of the movie to see Atlas and Smith work together so they can complete their mission of defeating Harlan. Okay, so I'm going to give this film 2.5 out of 5 stars. There are different types of conflict in fiction. One of them is man against machine, and I thought that this movie was man against machine. However, when I watched the last half of the film, and you learn the details surrounding Atlas's mother's death, that's when I realized that the story is really... the conflict is really man against himself instead of man against machine. So because of that, it kind of took me out of the film. And also, I became emotionally detached from the story as it progressed. Another thing that I realized is... even though the movie is not technically preachy, the lesson that I walked away from this whole film is that AI, just like everything that humans have invented, AI is just a tool that can be used wisely or that it can be misused. But the problem with AI is that many of us, including myself, are not very optimistic about AI as we were when the arrival of other forms of technology came along within the past 30 years, like you know, the invention of PCs, the internet, Windows operating system, the cell phone, the DVD, the Wi-Fi. You know, these were inventions in the past 30 years that human beings were optimistic when they came along, and they were happy that the technology was developing towards a better place. But AI is something that most of us are not, well, some of us are not, you know, we're very skeptical when it comes to AI, because AI raises problems for many people, while others, some few swear that AI is another wealth building opportunity. So it all depends on how you look at AI. Not only do I have issues with Harlan, but I also have issues with Smith. The AI robot is basically a car, an airplane, a submarine, a shrink, a surgeon, and a computer programmer all in one machine. That bothers me. That could be, it could go back to the reason why I distrust AI. I don't know. I'm just saying. Another issue that bothers me, and what stood out for me was Jennifer Lopez's acting. I'm a longtime fan of hers, so I never had this problem before, but I actually thought that her acting was not believable during the first act of the film. Like the first 30 minutes of her being on screen, it's as if she didn't believe the environment that this movie took place. I don't know. But the first half of the first 30 minutes of her being on screen, she didn't come off as believable to me, and I'm not quite sure why. I felt like the rest of the acting team was very good. So I'm happy with the overall acting of the cast. Simu Liu, Sterling K. Brown, Mark Strong. I think they all gave very great performances. But me personally, I thought that she did a much better job with Mother. That's another movie that came out last year on Netflix, The Mother. I thought Jennifer Lopez gave a much better performance in that movie than here in Atlas. But overall, the movie was just okay. I personally am not going to watch it again. I think once is enough. So if you have watched Atlas, let me know what you think in the comment box below. So that's all for today, my friends. I will see you next time with another movie review. Until then, take care and have fun streaming.